Working with scan meshes instead of parametric models can present some unique problems for machining. In particular, missing facets, holes, or bores in scanned data are common sources of incomplete scans or inaccurate geometry. Let's step through how to edit and repair these typical scenarios on our bicycle suspension arm mesh. We've got some facets missing in the pivot bore of this mesh from our scan that we need to deal with. This is something you'll see often with raw scan data, as cavities are much harder to capture as complete watertight entities than the exterior surface of the scanned object. To add to the problem of holes in the mesh, we've also got to make an engineering change to increase the diameter of the pivot bore. I've got a wireframe circle already drawn that represents my new target bore size. My first step here will be to extrude a solid cylinder to trim the mesh back to. I'll select my bore wireframe, set the distance to 10 millimeters, and turn on both directions to make sure I extrude well past the extents of my arm ear. Next, I want to copy my wireframe and my cylinder and place them in the opposite arm ear. I'll select both and do a dynamic transform. I'll use the keyboard shortcut C to snap to the wireframe circle center and then translate the selection set along the Z. By default, MasterCam only allows snapping to vertices on open mesh edges. We can change that by going into selection settings and unchecking this selection choice. I'll do this and then select No on the configuration pop-up to leave my default configuration unchanged. Tab can also be used as a shortcut key to temporarily allow the same selection method, though only when we don't have an active measurement field like here in Transform. I'll select the bottom edge of this bore pocket to place my wireframe and solid cylinder in the same location as the left arm. Now that I have my cylinders in place, I'll open up Trim to Surface Sheet in the Mesh tab. This command allows us to split or trim meshes based on a variety of geometry, including solid bodies. I'll select the suspension arm as the mesh to trim, and choose the right cylinder as the body to trim with. I'll also turn on Create Cap to attempt to automatically cap the trimmed area, and then click OK to finish. Turning off Level 2, I can get a good look at how the trim command has removed the troubled area and perfectly capped my new enlarged bore. Let's show a slightly different way to accomplish the same thing. I'll open Trim to Surface again, this time selecting the mesh and left-hand cylinder, but making sure Create Cap is off. Clicking OK to finish up and turning off Level 2, I can see I now have an open hole in my mesh body from where I've trimmed away the mesh. This is my next problem. How would I go about capping this hole on my own? I'll change my active level to Level 1, and then go to the Surfaces tab and make a drafted surface, using my wireframe circle as the input geometry. I'll change the length to 4 millimeters, which is the thickness of my arm ear. I'll now go back to the Mesh tab and choose Meshes from Entities. For the command selection, I'll choose both my drafted cylinder and my suspension arm mesh. I'll turn on Combine Selection into a single mesh, and also choose to delete the original entities. What I'm doing here is both turning my surface into a mesh and merging it with the rest of the suspension arm mesh at the same time. I'll click OK to finish, and now we've got two perfectly healed bores at our new size. There's one more problem to fix in this file, however. Rotating the model, I have a few facets missing right in the middle of this concave profile face. Let's launch the Modify Mesh Facets command to address them. Modify Mesh Facets is a powerful tool with a few different use cases. Create Mesh would take our selection and copy it as a new individual mesh body. Remove facets would allow deletion of individual mesh facets. Remove facets and create mesh would take a selection, trim it from the mesh body, and place the trim facets into their own new mesh entity. Finally, repair is what we're going to use here to try and heal the facets in this area. For larger holes, we'd want to use the actual command fill holes, but let's just see what repair gives us here. I'll select repair and then choose a target. Facet selection here is done using a paintbrush. Left clicking and holding allows me to scrub the part surface and select any mesh facet that is either completely inside of or intersects with my brush boundary, depending on my selection method. I can make my brush bigger or smaller using the radius slider, and I can also unselect entities by right clicking and holding and again scrubbing around. I could also select single facets one at a time with the mouse, but the brush is the more versatile selection tool in most circumstances. Clicking OK to finish up selection, I get an automatic preview of the repair and my hole is filled. But the surface curvature doesn't match up very well anymore. Let's click OK to finish up and accept our mesh modification and use a different tool, Smooth Area, to fix our curvature. Here, I want to modify the existing body and leave the selection at facets. Clicking to select the target, I get my brush interface again. I'll make my brush radius a little larger here, and then left click and hold and scrub around the repaired flat area and some of the surrounding original curvature, then click OK to finish up facet selection. We have a large number of smoothing options here, but for this attempt, I'll use Minimize Curvature and then click Preview. We can see that this did an excellent job of getting back to the original shape of this surface and fixing the repair bump. We can make it even better by changing the maximum iterations from 1 to 10 here, then clicking Preview again. This is a small selection set, but on larger meshes or selections, this iteration count has a big effect on calculation time. These changes to restore the original curvature of the repaired area look great, so I'll click OK to finish with Smooth Area and accept the results. We've completed our engineering change and repaired the gaps in this mesh while keeping it a single mesh entity and retaining the original surface curvature, all made possible by the new suite of mesh tools in MasterCAM 2022.